The death toll continues to climb in the Indonesian province of West Papua, with confirmation a student has been killed during an attack on a dormitory in the Papuan capital, Jayapura. Hundreds more security officers have been flown to the region after a week of some of the worst pro-independence violence seen in decades. Scott Morrison was questioned today on Australia's response, hours before four Australians were told they'd be deported for participating in demonstrations in West Papua.
Abepura district in Jayapura, where West Papuans say they remain under siege. Sources contacted by SBS say a 21-year-old Papuan student was killed during an attack on a dormitory in the early hours of Sunday morning. They say Michael Karat died from a bullet wound to the chest, fired at close range. At least 16 other people were injured.
He died because of the gunfire by the civil militia direct to his body. I'm still in danger because difficult for me to get out from here, from this place, because all the places still monitored by TNI and police all the way in Jayapura.
Witnesses say students in the dorm had called on help from security forces at midnight after Indonesian civilians with weapons had gathered. They claim the attack happened 2 hours later. It's alleged security forces were present at the time. More social media videos have trickled out from the region. This one appears to show Indonesians carrying machetes in Jayapura as some members of the group rally others to join them. This confronting video aired on SBS News last night, appearing to show Indonesian forces opening fire on Papuan protesters in Dayi, saw 8 people killed, according to witnesses. A specialist on the region says it's the worst violence seen in West Papua in decades.
This is a very serious situation, and there's been nothing like this for at least 4 decades. And that was back in the days when the Indonesian military cracked down in a way that led to the deaths of thousands of people.
The Prime Minister's response today on the escalating situation.
This is a matter that the UN is dealing with the current human rights investigation, and that's got the full cooperation of the Indonesian government, and we'll await for the outcomes of that process.
Australia is unlikely to intervene in part because of a treaty signed with Indonesia more than a decade ago.
Australia is not likely to ask the United Nations to intervene in any way for a number of reasons, not least of which is the Lombok Treaty, which precludes Australia's intervention in West Papuan matters and respect for Indonesian sovereignty. And the UN Security Council itself is very unlikely to want to become engaged in this particular issue.
Port Moresby's governor is calling on the Indonesian government to respect the will of West Papuans for an independence referendum.
In Indonesia, that they must accept its reality and they must go back and fix it from the beginning. That means giving our people that right that they are entitled to under international law. One person, one vote.
4 Australians will reportedly be deported from Indonesia after participating in West Papuan independence protests over the past fortnight. Indonesia's security minister has described the situation as peaceful, but sources say many West Papuans are now in hiding. Virginia Langeberg, SBS World News.